drive from Berg-en-Dal before we check out.
7.
It's still a bit dark out. Yeah, nice orangey colour over there. Sun's coming up. Just taking a slow drive here, just trying to see what we can see. Got Jazz on the torch. Trying to spot something in the bush. To be out. Big old snail. Hope it doesn't get run over by anything. He's still got a way to go to get to safety. It looks nice with the hills over there. Come on guys, don't be shy. Just because you're on camera now.
I can hear noise.
You hear the noises, man.
Oh, he's gone now.
Jasmine.
Good morning. It's breakfast time.
This is the breakfast area at Le Wasabi.
Not
Le Wasabi. No, Berg-en-Dal.
Someone needs his coffee.
Yeah. Coffee is on the way. Managing to sit outside today because it's a lot sunnier. What breakfast are you going for?
This one.
This morning. Okay.
Lion Run one sounds quite good as well, but I think a cheese griller. It's a sausage.
I wasn't sure on that. I don't know.
That's what it was at Wimpy.
What are your thoughts on Berg-en-Dal as a camp, as an area for game viewing, as in general your experience?
Yeah, really nice. Very nice accommodation. Restaurant's good. Food's nice.
What about the shop?
Shops, okay. Yeah, got a lot of the stuff you need. I think it was just a fact it was all meat was frozen, but I don't know if that's going to be the same at the other camps or not.
What I'm wondering now.
But yeah, it was alright. Got all the snacks we needed.
Got a long drive ahead of us today. Going from Berg-en-Dal down south, all the way up to Satara. Gonna take about at least 6 hours, the book reckons. So hopefully we see some stuff along the way. But otherwise, just gonna take it easy and enjoy it. Still his horn. It's one of his horn. Actually, the one at the back's got a big horn. See. The other one's coming up now.
Makes sense for a Berg-en-Dal to have rhinos on their sign.
Yeah. Is there a fourth rhino? I thought there was four.
I think there is four.
Oh yeah, that's the fourth one. I think three of them might have horns.
wonder if two of them are quite juvenile though, which is why they haven't been dehorned just yet.
Yeah. Do rhinos stick together in like a family?
They can do, I think, for a bit.
If that's water or a mirage. Guess we'll find out.
Are those elephants really there? Or is that a mirage too?
That's a big one. Big boy. Well, probably
that's
good.
A cow.
Is it? What's that thing hanging down?
Good point.
I've zoomed in on it. Sometimes that can be things falling out, isn't it? Like prolapsed.
Yeah.
Nice to see Gnu.
You must not really get them round down by Berg-en-Dal.
No, it's not.
I think they prefer these like grassy plains.
Not wildebeest country down there, is it? It's tortoise country.
It is tortoise country.
One second. Point where you're at to get out from your vehicle. You're in Skakuta. Stopped on the way. It's near Kruger Shalati Hotel on a train on a bridge.
Yeah.
Oh wow.
Check out the nads on this guy.
Oh my god, Jazz.
Got a pal over there.
Definitely a boy. That's Norman Parler.
Is that a pal?
Just joking.
Nice. Some rays. Where's the wings? Do you think they stick the wings out to cool down?
Yeah, maybe.
Got a snail on its beak.
That one elephant's got a big lump on its side. Look at them playing in the water.
Chasing the birds.
He's cheeky, that one. Look at him.
Next.
Well, apparently at Shokwani picnic spot, heading up this tar road all the way to Satara. Might take a while, so I have to push it because it's now 2:30. We need to close at 6:30. So I'm sure we'll make it, but just to be safe.
We were hooking on gas getting to Satara, but we're a bit held up a bit. Yeah, cooking on gas for approximately 2 minutes. Big Ellie here had other ideas.
Ooh. That car over there is keeping his distance as well.
He's a big boy.
That Ellie's gonna go that way.
Summer in the bush. Not sure where it is. Oh, I'm going a little bit more and then we can be on our way. Off he goes, and we're good to go. Right, Agatha. Mark,
We've got a long drive today, and while I have had a little snooze because I may have been getting a little bit grouchy, Mark has not.
I don't see how I'm being grouchy.
Even the way you said that was grouchy.
Oh, I just don't understand how I'm being grouchy.
You do.
Hey, you're supposed to be looking for a cheetah that side, not filming me.
Oh no, not grouchy at all.
Find me a cheetah!
So we're between, what road are we on? Is it the H2?
We're between Shokwane and Shokwane.
Between Shokwane and Satara, and it's very different terrain to what we've been seeing in Berg-en-Dal. How is it? Berg-en-Dal, yeah. The last few days. Where it's more kind of like thick, knobthorn, dense knobthorn, whereas here it's just a knob. just sort of more open savannas. It's a nice tree over there. Any leopards in it?
Down by the river, anything?
Bit of some water.
Water. Big tracks, I think there's elephant tracks down there.
Yeah, but nothing much to report.
Anyway, we'll come back to you later, but maybe when this one's had a coffee or a nap.
Bye.
Very busy here at this pan today.
Oh, there's a beast over there too.
So, water buck. Another one there. Another one there. Some more under that tree. Paula. Wildebeest. Three kudu bulls. some baboons over there as well. Very nice and peaceful. Sounds like there's some water up ahead and something in it.
The head's pushed this side, haven't we?
No. Long drive? Very long drive.
We left at about 9. Just going to get checked in.
This is the kind of like restaurant bit at Satara. There's Jasmine. Shop and reception. Yeah, first impressions very good.
Hello, Mark.
Hello, this is our Berg-en-Dal number 174 here at Satara. We just picked up the keys from reception, so we're gonna go see what we feel. We've got our perimeter fence view. Outdoor in the kitchen, fridge on the outdoor, big gate to stop from the baboons.
Take long.
Maybe. Ah, there you go. We're in. basic. It's a lot more basic than the one we had in Berg-en-Dal, but you know, this would be a decent enough base for the two nights.
Window
conditioning going.
Oh, they're being so far away from each other, look. Oh, but this is better, look. Put a light above your bed.
Handy, yeah.
Cool. I think that's a woodland kingfisher.
That baboon just sort of sitting on the twig down there.
This guy?
Yeah. Oh, so I can't see the limping.
There's one there as well.
I know, I've seen him. What the hell?
check out the sunrise behind us. Down by the pool, just in for a swim. Mark's living a real hard life, as you can see. It's very warm today. It's a shade, it's too hot. Over. Hi, Mark. Enjoying your dip. That is hot. Like maybe he's, one of his eyes has been taken out.
No, I think they're okay.
He's just got it closed.
This is a mug.
just here at the picnic spot, and Jazz has noticed some interesting prints.
Those little babies are playing with each other, but I don't think they've got any teeth, like very big teeth yet. Trying to bite each other.
I reckon there's a crop between those two hippos. Back and strength.
Hello.
Hello.
What have you got behind you there?
Whole herd of buffalo. And they're holding up the traffic. We're all trying to get back in time before the gate closes. But they're not playing ball.
Yep. What is the time now?
About 22 minutes.
Still got a few K to go as well.
Gonna make us late. You and your buddies.
Stop playing that. I'm sure he's got a gap.
bright
Friday night in the bush.